We are live on CWTFB with DJ Chizzle. Yeah. Yeah. This is Meechie Columbia. I'm here with 2GP, my man AR-15. Get it.
Let's go. This is CWTFB Radio. I am your host, Charlie MaSheen, alongside my right-hand man, Cash No Motherfucking Money. What's good, boy?
What's up, baby? Over here trying to get some out your pocket.
Yeah? Man. I mean, I'm out of dropped a few dollars, my nigga.
Nickels and dimes, you gotta be nickels and dimes.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You know, I like, you know, nickels and dimes, man. It was my guys, my nigga. Fully out there. You know what I'm saying? You heard? But, you know, it's episode 80.
Ooh,
episode 80, man. Episode 80, always sponsored by Details Car Audio and Auto Detailing, right on 925.
It's only right, you got an 8 in it. My fault. Go ahead, continue.
8 plus, right?
Hey! Damn, that was full circle.
It makes sense.
Always sponsored by Details Car Audio and Auto Details. Details, baby, details. Turnpike Street in Canton, Mass, Route 138. Run up in there for all your detailing needs. Interior, exterior, clay waxes, car accessories, truck accessories, motorcycle accessories, all of the above, man. My people will look you, have you looking clean, fresh, laced, and all of that, man. But I want to jump straight into it, bro. What you got for this week, man? What's up, man? How was your last 7 days?
Shit, man. Milwaukee Bucks. I want to talk about it only because
they four.
It's even right now. It's even right now. Even right now. It's best of 7, 2-2 right now. I didn't talk about it, but niggas who know me know what my pick was before the series, Milwaukee and 7.
Okay.
For you foolish niggas, understand that defense wins championship.
Okay.
All right.
So don't be,
games
don't,
of championship.
It's simple, bro. It's simple. That's a equation we all know.
Okay.
So don't lose your mind now. You know what I mean? I know Chris Paul. I know it's fairy tale. It looks I know. We all want it. I
we
get
all
it.
Want State Chris
Farm.
Paul to win.
State Farm commercial every 17 minutes.
Right.
Bro, it's easy to love that nigga, bro.
Right, right.
You know
what
I mean? But
I'm sorry, my man.
He's coming
though. Giannis, you got Giannis.
Yeah, Giannis. I got Giannis.
Seven.
Yeah,
I got Giannis.
You got the Greek.
Yeah. Because I mean, that's
about to take this.
Because good. That's where good basketball is happening. Because right now the USA, they just beat Argentina, but bro, they choking. I don't know what's going on.
I'll tell you like this.
What you got for me?
LeBron ain't in the finals, so I ain't.
So you don't
it.
Care. I know. But that's all I got for NBA because I had to get that out. I didn't give nobody
LeBron's
my finals
chip.
Prediction, so I had to get my finals prediction.
LeBron is chip.
Hold on, chill. Don't do that.
No, we're not going to do that.
I do want to mention
don't
something.
Do that. We're not doing
go
that.
Ahead.
I want to mention some shit I seen on Snap. You heard of Mal Karen?
Mal Karen.
Mal Karen.
We're going to talk about a Saxon.
Saxon. This bitch tried to attack some black woman. I guess she was trying to get some free panties at Victoria's Secret or some shit. I don't know what happened.
That line must have been long.
I don't know what that sale looked like, right?
You said the nigga name is Sazon?
No, Saxon.
Anglo-Saxons.
Yeah, that's what we call. That's what we call the
white.
That's what we call the white. The white.
So
wait, say his name one more time.
Saxon.
That sound mad nasty.
Yeah, that's what they did. They came in.
That sound like
the bitch
mad.
Threw
it.
She
sassy
she threw.
She, it's too.
That's sound like right.
I don't know.
Right
you gotta put too
players.
Much yeah, on that. You gotta put.
You gotta think about
too much
that.
Curl
like a,
on that.
Like
too
a,
much.
That's like a fancy store. Saxon.
Saxon.
You feel what I'm saying? Saxon.
So you know what, man?
All of us
fuck
in this room.
Fuck Karen, man.
Spend $500 for some Saxon. You know what I'm saying? Everybody in this room.
I'm not doing that.
We see little baby pull some Saxon. I'm in a view with my new Saxon. They're gonna be like, yo, I'm
on it.
Motherfucking
Saxon.
We sold it.
You
should have
gone. You're not lying. You're not lying.
We sold it.
Saxon is fine.
You know what?
These Saxons are going to hunt it on me.
Niggas is warmed up. We just going to bring these niggas in, man. Because you know, we got some legendary hitters in here, man. Some niggas from the city, man, that's been making a lot of noise for a very long time. They name ring bells in many different
Columbia.
Circles, man.
From a legendary hood.
Legendary hood, man.
Legendary.
Columbia, man.
Right.
Make some
to
noise.
New.
Put your hands together for my man, AR Godda.
Uh-huh.
Meechie Columbia.
Gang, gang, gang.
None other than 2G, like Gucci, you heard? Go, baby.
Yeah. This is nice.
Thanks, what up, fellas?
What's up, baby boy?
Shit,
big dog.
Shit, I'm chilling,
baby boy in a Mercedes
man.
Toy.
Yeah, it was
that's
good
not
y'all,
a rental,
man.
Nigga. You know, you're getting money.
How y'all feeling, man? I'm glad y'all here.
Shit, we blessed, man. Y'all
niggas looking good. Hey. Nigga got a life-size angel on his chest, nigga. That's this, a got, nigga got Tinkerbell on his chest.
This is a loan, nigga.
Jesus.
This is a loan, nigga.
Looking good, baby.
So what's up, man? What's up with y'all, man? Let the people know who y'all are for the people who don't know, you know.
Meechie Columbia. I come out of Columbia Point. I'm a nice new artist coming up. I'm trying to get my name out there for the crowd.
It's a fact.
You know what I mean? Put on for Boston.
Word. I mean, hey, y'all.
It's your local neighborhood Point, nigga.
Yo. Speaking to the mic, bro.
It's your local neighborhood Point, nigga. Ayo, you can catch me wherever. Strangely. Anywhere, surprisingly. You know what I mean? So I don't, you know.
Feel me?
But 2G.
Like Gucci. You know what I'm saying? 2G's like Gucci, man. You heard?
Yeah.
Big 800, big Columbia. You know how we rocking like a cutoff stocking, man. Wolves, Hun, Sheet, 1 to 10 deep, man. I got the guys with That's me. You it, feel bro. Me?
Mm-hmm. Guys. So it's a family like affair, that, man. It's a family That's affair.
Yeah. You could tell. Niggas sit. Niggas have Thanksgiving together, my nigga. Yeah. Pass me the Mac, my nigga.
Even in the joint, though. Yeah.
We be cooking out in the hood. No one making no older. You know, elders always cook for you. Know,
Yeah.
It be us.
Right,
motherfucking the dudes that y'all see rapping.
Right.
Yeah, we flipping burgers, nigga. Like we ain't getting paid for that shit. I'm one of them. I'll be over there like this. You know what I mean? Get you a burger, cheese.
Whatever.
I just whatever.
Hook the people up.
Shit like that.
Oh, shit.
So let's talk about life in Columbia Point, man.
Yeah.
Because you know what I notice about the Point, man? It's like if you ain't got no business in the Point,
you'll
never be in the
Point. No. You look at it on a map.
What you out here for?
Right.
On a map, it's on a point. On a map, it's literally on a point. So like for you to go to that point, you gotta point to be there.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So it's like, with no point to be there, you gonna get hit with some points.
Some pointers.
It's a fact. Or you scoring points. It's either one or the other one. You know what I mean? So it's like, life over there always seemed like it was an island, but it was really just a cut. It was really just a
little cut.
Wavy like that.
A dangerous cut. Back there was a dangerous cut.
It's like a hood utopia type shit.
We enjoy certain luxuries niggas don't enjoy.
And what is
what
that?
I mean?
Like the water.
That water.
Okay.
Ooh,
automatic dick suck.
Okay. People come to
immediately. You see that shoreline? I'm dropping mine. Let's go.
Sand, little towel. Why not?
Cold red. That's what I call it.
Automatic.
Automatic.
I can't
my dick shit.
We're going to say five.
What you
We're going to say 10 plus years.
Okay.
Or I want to say 8 to 7. You know, people got wives.
Right.
I had beach experience on that beach. You know what I mean?
Like
I
had nice
beach experience.
Beach experience.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Go have some beach experience if you're not
really
the beach.
Did have a beach, son.
Yeah.
They really had a beach the whole time.
The whole time.
Water boys, you see?
The water boys. Back.
They really had a beach the whole time.
Yo, what's up? What's up with Slaughter, man?
Cool and free him.
Free Slaughter, man. That's my guy. Yeah, I mean, like 13, 14 years old, man.
Got a short due date.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Real soon.
Okay. Free that, man, yo. Good nigga, man. Good nigga, man. But 2G, man, I want to talk about your history in the music, man. You know, you used to go by Punchy.
Punchy is just the hood name, so I'm saying.
Okay, but you used to rap under Punchy as well, right?
That's because I thought I was just gangsta. I could just rap and put up videos. None of my old videos is like popping. Now we playing shit together. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So that's why it's more organized and it's 2G like Gucci. And it, you know what I'm saying?
Can't say it's really popping. Like, it's legendary. We come from under that. We come from under that. You can't say it started
this barbecue shit.
You feel what I'm saying?
Because your name is legendary.
We come from under that.
That's just fact.
You feel what I'm saying? We, I watched that.
Everybody knows the name.
What's it called?
So I watched that.
Worst best critic? I don't know. Best worst critic? If I ain't on my ass?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You got to be hard on yourself so the world won't be.
I can't even watch that shit. Like, it's certain. Once that shit, I don't even watch it no more.
Why is that?
Just because, nigga. We got no bullshit. I got $1 million in my phone, folks. Like, no bullshit. I don't live. Once it hit, that's for the airways. Like, I got so much shit that from all of us collectively, like, I don't think it's too many places that could say that. Mm. Like, it's always like one, like maybe two niggas right. that's all
right. Right.
Nigga, we got a whole roster of shit. Like, you feel me? Like, right. shit,
yeah. I love my
like,
hood.
If we all go to the studio, it's like Coliseum. It's like all like gladiator shit. Niggas yeah. is taking niggas out and we enjoying it too. Like, it's all a murder spree, bro. Like,
that's fire. Right. That's fire, man. So let's talk about recent shit, man. My shit that got me hip to your recent shit, 2G, was
Big Dog.
Before that was Murder One. Murder One.
Big Dog.
Big Dog was heavy.
He hates that song.
Big Dog was heavy. Big Dog.
I dropped my daughter off in the whitest neighborhood. And I pumped that shit with my windows down, nigga. Uh-huh. Big Dog.
White people be at the Dunkin' Donuts like, yo, this nigga.
Nigga be with the windows down looking straight at a Big Dog.
Yo, Big Dog. I almost took some shit off.
Yeah, exactly how they looking.
She's looking at you like that.
Exactly how they looking.
And they're like, yo, get this nigga the fuck out of here.
That's my joint. Go ahead, go ahead.
But I was talking about Murder One, man. Murder One helped me realize that you was tapping into like a different form of artistry, right? Because when you was punchy, it was less melodic. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
The wave was different. The ad libs, the just the aura, the whole record was like, I was like, oh, this shit's refreshing.
Right, right.
You know
right.
what I'm saying? So like, what was going on through your mind when you made that record?
I ain't even gonna hold you. I was already in the studio. My man hit me like, yo, bro, talk that shit, bro. Mm. Like, nigga, tell him about that. I'm lit. I'm yeah. here. Like, yeah. you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, all right. I just went and said, you know what I'm saying? My man's out here. My man's here. Yeah. You feel me? Like,
be the murder one.
But I always, hey. Like, as far as the melodic tone, I had the melodic tone on choruses. Mm. So I'm saying? Right. And I probably felt like, nigga, I wasn't comfortable enough to express that all the way through on verses.
Mm.
So I'm saying? But, nigga, I you know what I'm saying? Punchy is it's sure abbreviation from punchlines. You okay. know what I'm saying?
Right, mm-hmm. right.
So I
right.
used to, you know what I'm saying? When I was, you know what I'm saying? A public kid or whatever, you know what right. I'm saying? You know what I mean? I used to have all the punchlines. Nigga, my real name's Austin, so they'd be like AP. You know
okay.
what I mean?
Okay.
My older cousin Frizz would call me AP, okay. AP, Austin Powers. You know what I'm saying? But, you know what I mean? KI here, you know what I'm saying? Nigga, punchline. He'd be like, yo, A, punchline.
Yeah.
Sending them saying, so it was, you know what I mean, niggas in my projects in my hood just punchy, punchy, punchy.
Okay.
Bar King.
Hey, yo.
Any city.
So where'd the name 2G Like Gucci come from?
2G's Like Gucci yeah. is just, you know what I mean, just tapping into the streets, you know what I'm saying, like, you know what I mean, two gun punch, you know what I'm
okay,
saying?
Okay.
It's just two gun punch, you know what I'm saying? Okay. The 2G's Like Gucci is just like something fancy for rap so I could sell myself. I'm not like trying it. To jack Gucci shit.
I like it. I like
but
it.
But it's just like regular, like I keep it like 2G's Like Gucci. You I like know it. What I'm
I
saying?
Like it. I like it, man.
So, you know what I mean? That's just what it is. You know what I mean?
It's packaged together well, my brother.
Yes, it is.
I appreciate is. You, yes. baby. I'm trying.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
It's a good look, my
So Meechie, what up? What's big dog.
With you, big uh-huh. dog.
Yeah. Doing it up. Now, with both of y'all on that record, Big Dog.
Yes, sir.
Well, gravitated. I knew AR since I was, what, 14, 15?
Kids.
You know what I'm saying? We was children.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is a reunion.
So when I see my man.
Nah,
straight up. Like, I think the last time I see you, I was like 16 years old, bro. Yeah, like, on some real shit.
Real.
So seeing you come home and then I see you on the record with Meechie, and I'm like, all right, this is beautiful. And before the song even came out, I saw you in the videos and shit like that, man. Y'all got a good tandem because yeah. y'all voices
yeah.
complement each other. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So like, what's up with the you know what I mean, the EP, man, the AR and the Meechie joint, man.
Sure,
you know
yeah.
what I'm saying?
I'm saying like we can do that, but you
that's
know what
not
I mean?
In
we
the go, works.
We gonna do that probably eventually, but yeah. you know what I mean? Right now we focus on Meechie. That like other project. Okay. Me and Jern Shock over here. We got the.
Okay.
We got the weed that's coming out because you know it's
quietly for
you. Once he gets in with us, it's automatic like destruction, like automatic, like you know what I'm
automatic.
Saying. I try to be humble.
I don't try to be.
You try to be humble.
Yeah, but it's like evident now.
You still
it's
playing like, to win though, my nigga.
Bro, I'm saying like, it just come a time for niggas, and I don't even like voicing my opinion towards our talent like that. Mm. I'd rather let the people do that.
We got you up here.
Let the music speak.
Bro, like, how could you not see that shit? Like, it's a difference. Mm.
Niggas,
I'm sorry. I don't know how niggas feel about this shit.
Niggas got distinct voices.
Call my jack.
Voices,
everybody
bro.
Got my jack.
Niggas got
call
distinct
my jack.
Voices.
You feel me? But niggas ain't fucking with niggas, bro. I'm sorry. To each his own. Life's a box.
When you hear Ayo, got a 15, you hear
Ayo. You
got
to eat spearmint sometimes. Eat them shits. You know
when
you
hear Meechiee Columbia, you hear Meechiee Columbia. Like, niggas got a distinct voice. You
right,
hear,
right.
Oh, this nigga's Jim Jones, or this nigga's motherfucking
everybody got their own sound.
Everybody got their own sound. So that's one of the things about.
It's just so much rappers. Too like there's just so many rappers in my projects.
There's a whole
and like we really trying to recuperate with our development. You know what I'm saying? With our projects,
right?
You know what I mean? The tragedies happen. We try and get it back together. There's a lot of rappers,
right?
That's coming out of our projects, and we right now it seems like how y'all calling us out right now,
right,
is the face to bring our projects up so y'all can have the next three somebody in our projects. Yeah, like yo, man, you've been buzzing,
right?
And you feel what I'm saying? Like, you turning up. We want to see what's going on with you.
My fault. Shout out to them dudes. You know what I mean? Shout out to Matt A-Side. You know what I mean? Like, the young niggas from our hood. You know what I mean? That's really... Mm. It's niggas out here that's really putting on it.
You know...
And you can see the development of Boston coming along, too. Yeah. Like, as a whole. Fuck my hood. Like, no disrespect. Not fuck my hood, but, like, side-step.
Right.
You know what I mean? But, like, you can see the whole Boston really trying to give a different sound to this shit.
Right.
And I respect that shit on dogs. Like...
Yo, hold on, Charlie. Free my man a whole lot of money, because he was, before he got booked, he was like, yo, check this out. 2Gs, what's up with the nigga? I need to be up there. Red Cups
really?
Of Rap. I
really?
Said, yo.
Really?
It's coming, bro.
I didn't even know.
Yeah, but
I didn't even know. But yeah, free that man, yo. Free
the eyes of the sky. The eyes of the sky.
You know what's crazy, man? Waterboys was the first niggas I ever seen on a billboard. In Boston.
Shout out,
and that's facts. Cold. I remember driving down Columbia Road, and I'm like, hey.
I know that, nigga.
I'm like, niggas in the city got billboards? And like, now it's becoming a more common thing, but like, this was like 10 plus years ago, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So like, that's what I mean, like, legendary shit then came out of y'all project, came out of y'all hub, bro.
I'm sitting between two legends.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, my nigga, you a legend within yourself as well, bro.
I ain't gonna give myself a legend.
Hold on, wait, time out.
Sitting between two of them. You got the battle rap king, and then you got just the bar king. I mean, you just got amazing craft. Like, he's just something different. Like, you feel what I'm saying? And I watched both of them.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? And growing up, I'm only 24. I'm only 24 years old.
You're the drill sergeant, though, my nigga.
You're the drill sergeant, my nigga.
You lead the marching band.
When it
comes
to versatility, whether it's drill, whether it's pain, whether, you know what I mean? Niggas ain't ready to mold like that, bro. You feel what I'm saying? Like, niggas ain't got that type of movement like that where they can sidestep into other lanes. Like, they can't do that what this dude's doing. That's what I'm saying.
Right.
And I'm going to speak on that again because I'm getting mad. This is what I'm saying. I'm a real, I think real shit.
I be like, damn, if Meek think shit like this? Do y'all think if AR-15 was not on Big Dog, would Big Dog be Big Dog?
Yep.
No, keep it real. This is shit that I see.
No.
Thank you.
No. And that's no slight to you. That's no slight to you.
Thank you. So tell this man.
But
what
I like about AR, what I like about what AR brings to it is the intellect. You see your fucking intellect in your music, bro. Yeah. You a smart ass nigga.
Good looking.
And you hear it when you rap.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, this nigga is fucking amazing.
Yep. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So like,
they all paint, like, Sisters thing. Slim told me artists paint pictures. AR
speaking
take
to the mic.
You. Pardon me. Hey, my man Slim told me artists paint pictures. AR take you here and here and here and here. So when it cut, like, when you see it in a video, it's like, You know what I'm saying? You see what's even not in front of you. You know what I'm saying?
Now look at what I'm thinking, right? I'm like a creator.
Right.
So when y'all see all these songs,
right,
these guys don't call me. None of them calls me. None of them, y'all. I got this crazy song for you. So when y'all ever hear these songs, Meechie Columbia, AR-15, 2Gs, Jerm Sharkey, Prophet Pat, y'all hear these songs, right? I'm calling them. I'm like, yo, I know this fit for you.
Let him tell the story.
I'm calling them. I'm like, yo, this song fit for you. Damn, I know this song. I know that you're going to turn it up. This I know. You feel what I'm saying? So
that's chill.
I don't give myself the best rapper. I give myself the best creator. I know what to do. I know what to put together. I know how to come together with anybody. Anybody in the city. Jizzle. Anybody in the city. Word. Like, not even just my own niggas. I know what to hit. I know what time to hit and when not to hit it. You feel what I'm saying? Like, all right, yo, you should do this song with this person right now because he's fire right now, and you're fire right now, and I feel like I'm just the hook king. I feel like nobody can beat me with the hooks right now. I feel like no one got me with choruses right now. You know what I'm saying?
That's where I'm at. My fault.
Nah, of course. I want to take the chorus. I'm Drizzy Drake in this motherfucker. Oh, nah. You feel what I'm saying? Give me every chorus, any hood you want, fuck it. If you ain't the beef, come get me right now. I got the choruses for you. You feel what I'm saying? You feel what I'm saying? I got it. You
ain't like that.
Hey, so how'd that come to be, man? That joint when you and Jizzle, man.
Me and Jizzle go way back. Yeah? Me and Jizzle, we really go way back in the connection. So when this right here is just something we already talked about before. Like, we going to be here.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? So when I see him going like, damn, I'm like, he's like, crazy. Yo, you coming here. Yeah. It's like, it's a blessing. You feel what I'm saying? And then, like, we going to link together every time, any chance we get to do music together, whenever it's free to us to do music together. But it's all out of love. It's like, we already told each other, we going to be here. You feel what I'm saying?
On the outside looking in, a lot of niggas was like,
Niggas don't care.
Niggas don't know.
None of that. Yeah, but me, it's like.
But you gotta understand.
You're gonna look at it like that because of what people think in the streets or whatever the case may be. Is we ain't gonna talk too much on that.
No, but I loved it though. I love the fact that you know what I mean? Because that's the shit that niggas don't talk about, right? Mm-hmm. You can have nigga from over here, nigga from over here.
Yeah.
But it's an individual thing, right? It's like, yo, look, man, like, the fuck? Ain't no music. Bullshit over here. Like, we
fuck with each other. I'm just promoting how I can rap, and I can show you my skill.
And if we could put it together,
show you everything.
Let's put it together.
It's a showcase.
And I loved it, my nigga. So because it confused niggas, I loved it even more.
That's right.
We're going to give a pain song to everybody because everybody thinking it's a controversy thing. You feel what I'm saying? So I'm going to clear that on the air right now. Like, that's really my man's. You feel what I'm saying? That's not no controversy thing in any other way. Like, we gonna do more music than that. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah. So I love that.
Shout out Ristol,
I love that, bro.
Niggas gotta do more music. Bro.
Nah, that
like,
fire.
Shame on them if they fire. Don't.
Appreciate
my nigga.
Nah, I appreciate
that
it.
That shit was clutch.
Y'all brought a lot of niggas out for that, man. It was dope, man.
I appreciate it.
For real. Hey, y'all, man, what's next, baby?
Man, I got a whole lot of shit on the table, bro. Like,
yeah?
I got like joint ventures that's like, like I said, shit with us. I got my own shit lined up. Like, I know a lot of niggas. He's bullshitting. Look. Hit me out. Can I stay my case?
Let the man speak.
I'm going to keep it real. And I need y'all to get everybody to get. This dude is the machine in the studio. You feel what I'm saying? So that's something different. You can't tell him. He's already in there. You feel what I'm saying? But as far as like a good project for himself, you feel what I'm saying? He got to tap into that. Like, that shooter's music, that shooter's tape that he did.
Right.
Cold.
Come on, my nigga.
We know that's a classic.
We know that's a classic. That shooter's tape that he did. We talking 2G. We talking 2G. That shooter's tape that he did was a classic. You feel what I'm saying? A classic. Now, what I'm saying with him is, he's waiting for you to call him. Like, any one of you out there.
Nah.
If you want to call him, he's waiting. Because he's not. I don't know what project he got.
Let him talk, man.
Shark, we don't know.
Hear me out. Shark, you. All right, let look. Him talk, man. Look. Hear me out. Look. All right, hear me out. I do be a little lacking on the pen tent.
Okay.
You know what I mean? You know, I, like, just recently. Nigga, Punch got me into tapping in and shit like that in the studio. Like, I'm coming off the top. My last, nigga, probably 10 songs been off the top.
Okay. Mm.
Nigga, I just wrote for y'all. Mm. Like, that's the last time I can't say I wrote since, like, I don't know. Years. I mean, years. Like, I don't really. But, you know what I mean? I got to get back to that because that helps my delivery. Yeah. I can actually, like, pinpoint what I want to. You know what I mean?
Right.
But
right.
Even then, like, the shit been coming out cold in a way. But, nigga, I got several different projects. Shout out to Ristol Roy. That's my beat maker.
Shout
on
out,
some real
shout
shit.
Out.
Okay.
Nigga, we got our little joint project going on. We got mad shit going on. Oh, Contract with the Moor coming out. You know what I mean? Shout out Nasirati.
Mm-hmm.
You know yes, what sir. I mean? We all just all about the progression, folks. Like, okay. We just, it's about to come. Like, y'all see what's about, like.
They know the singles is coming, but they talk about when is a.
When's the AR
mixtape coming out?
I want to be able to look you up on iTunes.
Do I tell y'all this or not?
I look, honestly, and this is what I've truly been waiting on. On some real shit, nigga, I've been waiting on this custom beat for a song that I want to make, and I'm not dropping the tape without that song on Dogs and No Bulls.
Yo, it's okay not to cut corners.
I'm dead serious. Look, hear me out. I wrote this song in 2014. I was in jail. No bullshit. I think that was probably one of the last shits. Probably like 2-3 more songs I wrote after that. But like, that's one of the last songs I wrote. Mm. On some real shit. You can ask any nigga that was upstate with me, bro. Anytime I dropped that song, it shut the whole shit down. Nobody wanted to rap after me, bro. Mm. And I'm not saying that. And I just want niggas to feel that. Mm. That's what I rap for. That's what I write for. I write for reactions. If y'all ain't noticed that,
right.
Like,
mm-hmm.
I want niggas to be like, "Oh my god, look what the fuck he said." I want that.
Right. Yeah.
It's a passion. It's not just like no.
And you get that.
You know what I mean? I want to take niggas.
You get that. You don't even really want it. You get it. You feel what I'm saying? It's like it's a natural thing with you. I've been watching this dude for a minute, so it's like. You're legendary. I'm between two legends, like I said before.
He's a legend. All right, he got to give his props in this song. There's
no
right
props. Sure. It's just,
you can't say the production
like
been
like
crazy.
Like he said, like he kept it real, and like everybody in this room knows, without you on Big Dog, and I knew that. You see what I'm saying? Like that's what I'm trying to get to the roots of it.
Yeah. Right.
I knew I could call up two. I could call anybody. I could have put two verses myself.
Right.
Yeah. I knew to call him for that one verse.
You got the air, my nigga.
You're going to switch a drill beat. See, I'm gonna come in. You gonna hear me?
I'm coming black.
He gonna slow you the fuck down real quick. Hold on, motherfucker.
Yeah.
He gonna Bernie Mac you real quick. Hold on, motherfucker. You feel what I'm saying?
Wait a minute, motherfucker.
He gonna calm you the fuck down, and he's gonna switch that shit up, and that's totally different. He's been like that for years. I've been watching since I was 14, 13,
that's
12,
fire.
Rapidly. You feel
that's
what I'm
fire.
Saying? That's just crazy.
That's fire.
I like
and,
that.
And that goes back to 2Gs, man. Because you've been in this shit for a minute, man, And I seen the recent collaboration with Shooters, man. How'd that come to be?
Shooters, first of all, I started Shooters when I came home 2014.
Really?
Speak that up. He said he started Shooters 2014.
My little cousin of Chilla, you feel me?
Yeah. Oh, Chilla's
okay,
your cousin?
Yeah,
oh, I didn't know that. Okay, you know okay.
Free him.
That's how that was.
Good nigga.
Nah, he out here.
I'm thinking about snacks. My fault. Free snacks.
Free snacks.
Free on
dogs. Free
snacks.
Free everybody.
Free the gels.
Yo, did you turn your phone? Yeah, your mic off, bro?
Nah, is it?
Oh, no.
You just want no homo. You want to. Charlie, don't do me like that. I'm a player for the Himalaya. But that's my little cousin, you know what I'm saying? So it's all, anytime I do something with them, touch base with them, it's all love.
Right.
But that's that.
Right. Family shit.
Family shit. You know what I'm saying?
All right, fair enough.
I came home, you know what I mean? Started something. I thought it was gangster, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I pushed it, but at the end of the day, nigga, when you an artist, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Everybody got their own vision. Some people got their vision of you. You got your vision of you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Some people see something bigger than you, and you even see bigger than you. You like,
right.
You really see that, bro? Like, you see that in me? You know what I mean? I wrote the Big Dog, and it's like, all right, cool. But I see people coming up to me like, yo, Big Dog is crazy. And I'm like, you really think so? Like, you know what I mean? So, too. You
but
got
that's
it,
not
bro.
The only crazy song Meechie got.
That's what I was gonna say.
Yeah,
I was gonna like,
saying, so,
like that's not it.
It goes back to the creator.
So you know what I mean? Like when you hear me on a Meechie song, you hear 15 on a Meechie song. Like I said, everybody got their own distinct voice.
Yeah.
But when you put it's a machine, bro. Yeah. Mm-hmm. When every piece, you know what I'm saying, go together, part. My nigga, it's a different vibe, you know what I'm saying? Right. So, and everybody gonna bring their flavor to the table, so you can't miss. It's like we hitting the OT block, nigga. Mm-hmm. Everybody coming with the back, nigga. Right. How the fuck you not gonna love us, nigga? Exactly. You know you don't got this out here, nigga.
Exactly. That Forrest is my shit.
Yeah, no Forrest.
Appreciate it.
Sneaky, no sneaky.
I just know when to come with him and know who to put on him.
Yeah.
That's just what it's about. That's what I like to do. I like to just come to, yeah, I like to
be the architect, basically.
Yeah, I like to orchestrate it. Like, yeah, bro, this one right here. I'm gonna do the chorus, and I think y'all two should do the verses. Like, that's me.
Right.
No, I don't always gotta be on a verse. I don't always gotta be on a chorus either. Sometimes you do the chorus, and I come in and do the verse. So, right.
Now you picked out that Black Rob shit for me and Germ too. That
Oh yeah,
Wall.
Whoa.
Oh,
so
yeah,
they
yeah,
got
y'all don't, y'all yeah. don't know. Y'all just know. Really don't know what's coming.
Cause I like his man. Bars. That's, you know what I mean?
The nigga got bars.
The murder one. Nah. No, listen.
Hurtful.
Y'all talk about the murder one, right?
He said it just like, yeah, I know.
The way you brought that in with the murder one is different because. It's coming different from punching all the elders,
right?
All the elders, I mean to say, that no punch from rapping back then. Right. Straight bars, right. No auto-tune, right. No nothing. He don't do right. No auto-tune, no nothing. He just, right. This is his voice. You right. Feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, like, when he come in with the singing on y'all, y'all like,
yeah,
bro, I knew you from 10 years ago, straight bars. You feel what I'm saying? And that's what I'm falling in love with. Ask me to tell you right now, I'm like, punch. Nah, go back to bars. Y'all remember when Dirk said, niggas is telling me to do bars, da da da, but this is what's paying the bills. And he's looking at me like that, but I'm like, nah, nigga, I missed them motherfuckers. Bar, how you come in a beat coming crazy.
Yo, what's your favorite punchy punchline? You got one? Have you?
Dudes
you
got probably one? Got better ones than me because you know what I'm saying?
I couldn't even think about it.
I'm always
I got
trying,
one, and
I'll
always bring
myself.
It up because I feel like it's always, I don't know, this is a hood song that really nobody really hears. But you know what I mean? This is my favorite song from my
what
hood
song
period.
Is that?
You'll probably never hear it, bro. I'm telling you, it's
no,
really
you should,
not.
You
it's
find
way
it. Actually,
back in the day,
it.
Like.
What's the line? What's the bar?
Give me the bar.
He said, I don't want to hear about how you let your semi blow automatic WAP jumping like Kobe with the mini fro. Niggas don't know Kobe with the mini fro.
Not the eight.
That's not the
eight.
Mini fro. Not the
eight.
That's what the moon shoes.
Not the eight.
That's Kobe with the moon shoes.
Kobe with the mini fro.
He's like, what song is that? What the? He's like some Wheezy shit.
Look at him. He don't even know. He don't even remember. And that's the crazy thing about him. Now I want to reach a whole nother topic because it's about to get real.
Okay.
No bullshit. This nigga got so many songs, bro. Mm.
Yeah, I told you.
So many
songs. Energize.
Let's talk about it.
I'm telling you,
bro.
My boy, he could put out.
Ask him the question. I should be asking this the question. My phone 15. When is the punchy? I be. This is the question that
I'm
asked.
Job,
this is
I'm
the, I say, when is y'all projects coming out?
Like, yo, that's
when
the thing, right?
15 and punchy.
No, we can do that too. Punchy or just
that.
Punchy
oh,
again,
okay.
Or
okay.
Just 15.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah,
just
but that is a great question, my nigga. When is that? When is
yeah,
that coming?
Up,
we're gonna get there.
I'm dropping two EPs. I got one, like you said, the sing song type, the vibey joint.
Okay.
And I got one with the balls on it. I got 15. I got nigga, bro. I got everybody on my shit. So as far as the hood shit, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So. It's more like niggas want to hear, like a lot of niggas, like you said, what made me start like tapping into the like the harmonizing and shit. When you always lock them in the system, sometimes, you know what I'm saying, niggas want to hear, they be like, yo, let me hear that shit, nigga, fuck that, you know what I mean, you in the hole and shit. They be like, yo, that shit fire. Nah, right. Nigga, keep fucking around with it.
Yeah.
Then you got niggas like, nah, gang, I want to hear that shit, gang, tap back in.
Right.
I ain't playing, gang. So then when I get into that, I got niggas that pull me back. Full. So I'm just trying to hit everybody, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but that becomes with being an artist, you know what I'm saying?
He ain't trying, he's doing. Like, he's coming here with it, and then he'll come here with it. That's you know what I'm saying? Like, he could do it all. That's why it's so crazy that you pointed out the murder one.
Yeah, fact.
Because I'm more with the bars. You feel what I'm saying?
No,
I'm more with the bars.
I love the bars. Right? Mm. Look, if anybody know me, nigga, they know I'm a rat. Yeah. Like, I
nah,
love
but
rap.
That losing like, myself. Like, losing myself is like.
No, but we're talking about punch. We're talking about punch.
I'm just saying, because you got to understand, nigga, this you going to hear Meechie aggressive. You might hear 2G aggressive. You might hear 15 aggressive. But then you might hear, you know what I'm saying, a song that, like, I want you to hear.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, you need to hear this, my nigga, whether you like
I
it or
not. I think Chizzle want to hear 2GP. Like, I'm just
Chizzle's three. Chizzle, make sure it's three of them.
Y'all that era, y'all, you see him when you was like 14, 15, 16. Right. You know what I'm saying? So y'all that era, they really want to a take from y'all, and I tell y'all this all the time. Like,
y'all getting it this summer.
A real live project.
That's it. So, I'm not entertained. Like,
so outside is open. So what's up? Shows? What's up?
What's up with the shows?
What's up? Shows, baby?
Hold on. I want this motherfucking anklet.
Meechiee. Oh, yeah.
I can't move. I gotta stop learning.
They want these glasses stationed.
I hope they see this interview. I'm doing something productive with myself.
Fact.
I got denied 5 times in court. They're not trying to let me get no passes to New Hampshire. Nothing. They don't want me to rock no shows.
They don't want
out
you
right
to
now
leave the state.
Yeah, they don't want me to leave the state.
Man,
I've been on this bracelet for 2 years. Well,
at least there ain't no time limit on your shit, real man. Shit. You know what I'm saying? There's niggas that gotta be home by 10 type shit. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? At least you can do
that. Shout out to them niggas. I hope them niggas are still striving. There's some motherfuckers that still striving on better on worse conditions than me.
Yeah,
you feel what I'm saying? This motherfucker still push. That's why that shit pushed me. Like, if I can be out 24 hours a night on a bracelet, still fighting the case, but you got a motherfucker that's still fighting the case but can't be out 24 hours a night, and he's still going like this, he's still going like this, and he's still going like this. You'd be like, yo, I can do the same thing and I got more options. You just gotta open yourself. You just gotta really be like, yo, I'm done with what I'm doing, whatever I'm doing. And just go jumping straight to that.
You had to do something, nigga, with your voice. This nigga got a crazy ass voice. Yeah, bro. He had to rap or something.
He had to rap,
nigga,
bro.
Or some shit, nigga.
Yeah, I've been rapping for a while time. I've been rapping for a long time. Like I said,
this nigga,
I give my credit to him, though.
Spot,
I give my credit to him because he brought me back with Big Dog. Y'all wouldn't know. Y'all wouldn't really. I'm not going to say y'all really wouldn't know because I'm going to keep pushing. I've been rapping for a long time.
Right.
And when he went to jail, nigga, I was watching him.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? I had a computer at my people's crib. I'm putting albums together in 30 seconds.
Wow.
You feel what I'm saying? Not 30 seconds, but like, you feel what I'm saying? I'm just freestyle putting it together.
Yeah.
Now, let me tell you. Let me tell you about 15, right?
And music.
Yo, 15, me, you know, that's my man. You know what I'm saying? We around the same age, so we come up together. You feel me? Like, sleeping, no homo in the bed, saying head to toe, you know what I mean? Back and forth, you know what I mean?
Whatever.
So I 15 used to, yo, you know what? Joey Jahad, like Bricks of Raw. Nah, listen, when Joey Jahad, Bricks of Raw, like shit like that was popping, like, you know what I'm talking about? The Philly nigga, the Philly freestyles. It was popping.
You put me on to a lot of them Philly niggas.
Right. This is the thing.
Yeah.
15 was the jock the Philly niggas shit. Switched the name with the beat. So I'm like, yo, this nigga is cold. I'm like, how the fuck?
Gassed him.
So boy, this nigga,
he'll
yo.
Be mad. Yo, he'll be
talk
mad when
about
I'm
it.
Mad. That's not
talk about tight. It. Talk about it, nigga.
Yo, bro.
He thought I'm blocking.
Because, bro, you know he with nigga every day.
Yeah.
And you don't understand, like, where did you have the time to make this shit up? I was with you all the time, man. You don't even do shit like
this. I just pick shit up, nigga.
Boy, nigga. He's so mad.
Yo, I don't know. One time, I just high as shit. It was like, me, I don't know what the fuck. I remember I had a Blackberry Pearl.
Yeah. With a little scroll joint.
With the ball not working.
Nigga,
it
was on YouTube. I was like,
fuck
out of it. I heard some shit. I don't know. I forgot who it was. My thing. I was kicking that shit word for word, but I was saying his shit. I'm like, nigga. I look at this nigga. He's still bumping his hand like,
hey, yo. Like, oh, shit. Hey, yo, hey, y'all, you capping like that, bro.
Yo, look, I say anything. I say anything. My whole mother don't believe me. She don't talk to me like that. She just don't give a fuck.
Nah, this nigga, look, no, listen, no, but
everybody's my
home,
cousin, everything. I don't
now,
give a
listen,
fuck.
When I came home and I heard 15, R.I.P. Ruck. Because, you know what I'm saying? Ruck was like, yo, you know, 15, Waterboy. I was incarcerated, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So he's like, yo, it's lit. So when I came home, because it's like, since we was kids, we was out thugging and bugging, but, you know, as adults, or, you know, not even adults, young adults, one in, one out. Right. So, bong, when I come home and I get to watch my boy, it's like, you see, niggas like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas see this is fire. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm going to make this. Nah, nigga, I could, then it's, nah, let me pop my shit. Now it's like, yo, that shit ain't bad, bro. Like,
yeah.
That shit real right.
That's pressure. Pressure.
Like,
yeah.
Pressure.
Like, shit good.
Pressure.
Good. Everybody, you know what I'm saying? It's expression. You feel me? I don't never like. You ain't never gonna hear me nigga talking down about none of my niggas, none of them saying if a nigga whack, I'ma say he whack.
I'm as glad. You as you should, nigga. As you should, nigga.
Cause niggas be like, yo, too, I need you to speak more, but you know what I'm saying? I'm soft spoken, you feel me? I'm more big on action.
You, nigga, you very outspoken.
My niggas is fire. Nah, I'm funny. I got jokes. I've been locked up. I know how to entertain myself.
This nigga, I posted a freestyle one time.
What?
What you say on the shit? I deleted your comment, nigga. I was like, this nigga 2G, man. This nigga, I forget what you said. You was like, yo, this or some shit like this.
Oh, yeah, he's good. Hold on, I was like, why is this nigga bullying niggas, man?
I feel like you was bullying niggas, dog.
Hear me out.
Talk about it.
Look, we in the studio.
Just gas me like you did them.
No, time out. No, hold on, wait.
You deleted it? I didn't know you deleted it.
Let me get my, I swear to God. Look, we in the studio.
Did I do that, dog?
Yo, did you stop? Hold up. We in the studio, Pete, right? So we in the studio. Uh-huh. We've been blacking for like 3 hours. It's been our time's up. He wants more time. The engineer's like, hold up, we got another person coming in after us. Cool. He's like, who's this nigga? Like, you know what I mean? We mad close with the engineer. God, who's this nigga? Like, oh no. So boom. He's like, I don't know, some backpack rapper. So the next song we do, what this nigga do? I'm not a backpack rapper. I went and made the backtrack after. I said, oh my God. This is the backpack rapper. Ayo, for no reason.
What's your beef with the non-gangster rappers, man?
Nah, I love non-gangster rap, but this is the thing. It's like, I've been fucking locked. I'm going to take everything out of everything. This is all we got. And I got to say something about this.
I got a question. So, about the non-gang rap, right? So if I was to say right now, I just signed it. If I said in one of my new songs that I signed a deal to whoever, OVO, somebody, right? I ain't signed that deal. I'm in an Airbnb at a big crib, BMWs outside of the lock, I signed a deal. And you see me come in this motherfucker, and you like, nigga, where the fuck Drake at? You know what I'm saying? Where the fuck the papers at? I ain't speak to none of the motherfuckers, and you came. How would y'all feel about me lying on that motherfucking track?
I agree with that. Yeah. I hate cap rap. We talk about this shit all the time.
Oh, this is cap different. This is a different category.
Nah,
let's talk about cap, shall we?
It's cap rap, right?
I want to hear what
you...
Because you said, I ain't seen 100 G's, but I seen 100 K's. Uh-huh. I'm in 100 killers, and I love that.
Uh-huh.
Because that right there
that's fire.
That bar right there was... That was authentic right there.
Because you don't even know. I didn't say I know 100 killers. Now I can look and I can see everybody in this motherfucking room, and I don't even know this motherfucker's a killer, but I bet you I can say I seen 100 killers my whole life. You feel what I'm saying? Like, you looked at him, you can say you seen 100 killers.
So that's wordplay, right?
Mm-hmm.
But then there's just straight lying.
Straight lying.
Right? Yep. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's wordplay. That's hyperbole, right?
Mm.
Ooh. You got a nigga that
we had English class together.
You heard me? I remember that.
You said hyperbole.
That was dog shit.
Nigga said hyperbole.
Smartness in his music.
You don't know what's coming out.
Hyperbole about to come out.
But then you got a nigga that'll just go straight left, right, and be like, "Yeah, you see me in the rolls or whatever.
I'm in the ghost."
And the nigga
niggas be written ghosts, though. They hit the yams and get in them ghosts. Niggas be doing that. Shoot this.
One thing I can say to you is if I'm talking about millions, if I'm talking about 800,000, thousands, cars, I'm trying to get there. Yeah, you see what I'm saying? You're going to hear it in the song, though. You're not going to hear it say, I got it. You're going to hear it say, I'm trying to get to this point.
Okay, so let's land that plane then. So what was your beef with said person that I posted? Or
I don't have no beef with anybody.
It's not beef. All right, that's the wrong word, right? So
I'm a clown.
Is it just wreck?
I'm a type of nigga, I'll wreck out real quick. I've been fucking down. Okay. So
I'm with
But I see some shit, that's like my engineer. Like we said, we cool with our engineer. My man posted somebody and then muted. And I heard it, I was like, nigga, you fucking shitting me. You didn't let me in here this week, nigga.
You kicking me out for this?
Because of that, nigga?
So it's like...
Yo, and it'd be crazy because that song that he's kicking him out for may be the one to blow before yours.
Nah,
bro,
that's
right?
not.
That's how
not,
I always look, though. No, sometimes...
Trust me, I heard
they
it.
They take anything. They take it. I've been jumped on the radio.
What is that? Oh, wait.
People.
Like, what does that sound like? What does that like, dude?
The labels take anything. I haven't been in jail and I haven't heard the song. And I know the lyrics back to back. Oh, that's real basic. I'm a writer.
Right.
And yeah. I'm saying this shit, and I'm like, damn, this shit's so fucking basic. And I try to put so complicated songs together, like, yeah, if I put this bar together, this motherfucker gonna be like, yo, he hit me out the park. Sometimes it don't even be that.
Right.
Sometimes it be some shit that the motherfucker went through 2 days ago.
Right.
Uh-huh. And you put the shit on there, and you said it basic. Yeah. My bitch fucking kicked me out because I came in late or some shit like that. You just say it in the right way.
And the niggas,
and this nigga's
nah,
like,
but you know, this is the thing. Niggas be high.
This nigga's like,
they understand shit like that.
Kick me out.
You know, niggas be stressing my bitch. Kick me out. Yeah, fuck that bitch, my nigga.
These niggas is just saying anything. Like,
bitch won't let me see my kid. Yeah, bitch won't let me see my kid. Like, yeah, I ain't see this little motherfucker.
You feel that shit,
nigga?
I'm
telling you, bro.
Niggas said, no bullshit.
But mine's is natural. Like, I don't think like that. No. Mine's is natural. Hey, what's come out?
One of my songs I really love from you, Meechie, though, is it's Blood and Blue Notes. Blood or Blue. Blood or Blue. Blood or Blue.
Ooh, blood or blue. You tapping into
a lot of niggas. A lot of niggas look at that title and probably listen to a couple of the first track. Like,
take it the wrong way.
Like,
he's a blood.
He's thinking it's blood, crip shit. Right. Like, all right, yeah. You listen. You like, yo. You tell, nigga. Facts. Who's really for the blood, nigga? Mm-hmm. Who really do it for the blue notes?
Yep.
Right. Yeah. You know what I mean? And that shit was, yo.
And it's like it's like for people. I appreciate it.
So you're right. You're a writer.
True writer. You're true.
Because I say blood a lot, and when I say blood, I mean family. Like, these are family. When I say blood, you feel what I'm saying. Right. And when I tap in with people and I get real close to them, I call them blood. Everybody blue is like, you cool. You blue.
Right.
Yeah. You 100.
I like that shit.
Oh yeah, he say blood and everything. Like, he's a blood. Like, nah, I'm not a blood. You feel what I'm saying? Like, my cousin's a GD. You feel what I'm saying? But I'm just me. I like the way of blood. You know what I mean? That's my family. And then Blue, you a cool dude. Like, you come around, you feel what I'm saying? You grab a bottle, you chilling. You crack a joke, you feel what I'm saying? You Blue, you Blue on you 100. Fire. You feel what I'm saying? But my blood.
I've never heard nobody put it like that.
That shit was perfect when I heard
and
it.
And you gotta put it like that because some people really live for that blood shit too. And some people really live for that crib shit. You feel what I'm saying? So you gotta explain that. I'm not saying I'm the toughest dog in the map. Some people really die and live by that. You'll go by that. So I'm like, nah, I'm not. I'm just gonna explain to you what I mean.
Right, like, right.
That's
right.
Not disrespecting y'all. Right. That's not disrespecting them.
The song was perfect.
You feel what I'm saying? Thanks. Appreciate you. I appreciate you for that one.
I like how you listen though.
Nah.
Yeah, Cash.
That's a tape that's not even. That's a tape that's not even out there like that.
They both, like,
but there's no bullshit.
Nah, he put me.
No, I'm listening. Listen, you sleeping?
Nah, he put me.
I used to get that nigga my iPod and walk off.
He told me
shit. Wow. The gradient, look, the gradient with the white middle. Nigga,
that's facts.
Remember,
nigga say, yo, you gotta listen to this nigga. AR got a 15. I was like, yo, what's that nigga's name?
I said, this nigga got the best rap name ever. AR got a 15.
Hey, yo, hold up. Shout out to B. James. Shout out to FNS Films. He just threw that on there.
Shout out.
I don't be knowing what to go. I don't even use.
Oh, that was you.
I just
that
go
was
day
you?
By day, and I
that's
just.
True.
Hey.
Fuego. You know what I mean? He just threw all three names on there. I'm like, because
I love that shit.
AR's like my original.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Godda is going to be the blood. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The blues might call me 15.
The blues. I like that.
Might call me 15. So, you know, to each his own, but I don't really care what I'm called.
I love the name.
You just going to hear
it. AR got a 15. I said, that's fucking
classic. Yeah, now I got to switch this shit on Spotify. Everything, man. I got you, gang.
So what do y'all feel like sets y'all apart from everybody else in the scene, man?
History. Mm. The history is crazy. Mm. Like, y'all have free Young CP.
Yeah.
Free Trap Money Troll. Free everybody that's in that system that was rapping. You feel what I'm saying? That before me. And I'm only 25 years old, like I told y'all before. And like I said,
you 24
even,
minutes ago.
Yeah, nah, yeah, I mean, like, I was like, but even before them, though, like, we got a lot of rap history in our hood. Mm-hmm. You feel what I'm saying? And that's where I come from.
Right.
And that's where I looked at. I was out handing out the what you would call Slim Dale's date, motherfucker, taking in blood and motherfucking blood. Y'all motherfucker, y'all got a head taping in blood. You feel what I'm saying? So, like, I was in my projects really handing those out at a teenager, young age, handing those out. There's people that I really looked at, A-Buster, Van, really seeing that coming through my hood at a young age. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I don't really visualize that.
Niggas up.
You feel what I'm saying? Like,
hearing those names brings me back to that time. You know what I'm saying?
You know how I knew niggas was trappers? Niggas had...
A-bus rappers around the Hershey balls. Right. I said, oh my God.
I remember seeing that. I said, what is that?
It was purple and yellow. I'll never forget this shit.
It's history. That's why. So what you mean by like what historic. Separates us? It's history. We got a lot of new rappers coming up, but they don't really have history in their projects or in it with rap. This is, I'm just saying with rap. We talking rap. Yeah, you know what I mean? There's a lot of history and everything else. But in rap, like I got a lot of history as a young rapper coming up.
Right.
I can tap into a lot of old hits.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? And remake them with them. Yeah. You feel what I'm saying? That's what they doing now in the game. They can't even remake them with the people that's dead and gone, RIP to them.
Right.
But I got stuff in my projects that y'all never heard. And I can remake them with them. That's you feel what I'm saying?
That's so amazing.
It's history. Yeah. That's why I just really think it's history. Yeah. It's real history. They got real talent, these guys right here.
Two G's.
I learned from them.
They all like that.
What I think that sets us apart is just the several different directions we can go. Right. Like, no bullshit. Like, I can't stress that shit enough. I go through my phone. I don't even listen to, like, regular shit. Like I told you earlier. Once it hit the airwaves, once that shit hit YouTube, I don't listen to it no more.
Right.
That Forest shit, I was bumping that shit crazy. That shit hit the YouTube, I don't listen to it no more. No lie. Like,
it's like the next one.
We got so much shit in, like... And it's like niggas don't understand the range that like.
I got so much new shit. I don't listen to nothing.
And even him, his catalog's crazy.
I believe it.
Like you got to think about the years he been doing. His catalog's crazy. He could take 12 songs.
But y'all 12 times. Y'all see they saying they got all his songs right. Right now,
I'm cooking. Look, he keep yo. Look, he keep bringing me down. Hold on. He keep bringing me down.
I get on these asses.
Can I speak?
I get on these asses.
Hold on.
Like I said, last videos with Godda, with motherfucking 2G. Who was they last videos with?
As far as what?
As far as by they sell. No. As far as by they sell, like they promoted that you seen.
Okay.
No, I'm going to say that you seen they fully promoted they sell. If they own a verse, I don't care if it was with another person.
Okay.
That they, which song have you heard new from Godda from 2G?
You're challenging me now. I don't know.
That nigga's drunk, man. You can't do that.
Shout out to Inspire Me.
Get it out there.
You're talking about solo records.
Solo records or even new features.
Talking about features.
New features or solo records?
This nigga putting niggas on the spot.
This is the type of...
He has a new video out, right? And we don't see Godda posting that on his IG.
Why is that?
We don't see him posting his verse.
Why is that?
You feel what I'm saying?
Is there a reason for that?
Hold up, wait.
Niggas feel like they can do better, bro.
These are fans. They like your music.
Coming from your perspective, right? Because y'all are family, right? So for you to say that, like, it makes you question, like, why is that? Like, why don't you want to
I feel like niggas always feel like they could do better. So at the end of the day, gang, I dropped this. It's fire for right now, but like he said, nigga, Forest is fire for right now, but till I make motherfucking losing myself, this is the new thing.
Right.
So at the end of the day, niggas would be like, yo, I pumped this hard as I could. I got this new pack. This is what it is now. So I'm saying, instead of like Bo be saying, you know what I'm saying? Like, nigga, you gotta understand, niggas is learning shit.
Right.
From the young homies, bro, like a lot of shit. He'd be like, yo, gang, this how you do this, this how you do it. I don't know how to do none of this shit, bro.
Right, right.
See what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, when he on niggas' ass, it's not negative, it's productive. Like, yo, this is how you supposed to do it. Yeah. This is how I'm doing. He got work.
I have to cut you off. I don't even know why I'd be seeing him as much as I see him.
Yeah.
You just did so much state time. You should be in Atlanta somewhere. You feel what I'm saying? I'm on a bracelet.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? I can't go nowhere. And this is the things that I stress to him off camera. I'd be like, bro, you should be there, and you should be doing shows there. You know what I'm saying?
You was just OT, there, right?
Yeah, I'm all.
He's OT. No, don't get it fucked up. He's OT, but I'm talking about music wise. And they can go relax and go be with a. You can go relax and be anywhere. But it's not work. It's not a job. You're more spending than anything.
It's a coconut, not a microphone, nigga.
That's a fact. If I go somewhere, I'm not. Anything. I'm not supposed to be out my pocket like that.
You should be rapping. Like, you should be like, yo, why
don't you? You like, yo, what you doing? I'm over here on the beach, yo.
No.
Call me back later.
Y'all can tell me why you ain't in New York at a motherfucking regular show at
I don't give a fuck if it's maximum 400 motherfuckers. Right. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But I don't see that content popping up on your shit when you got the chance to before you never have the chance to. You feel what I'm saying? Or can got I the chance to at something? The time being.
And this is another thing that probably boosts us up. As you can see, we just respect each other's crafts all crazy, bro.
Yeah,
like when you observe shit,
Fuck respect. You just look at a motherfucker and you be like, nigga, I just know that you got something different than me. Like he can go on, not to cut you off.
Nah, you good.
But what's the motherfucking name with the beard from like, I know Boston motherfuckers. What's the nigga with the beard in New York with the radio station that them nigga Meek and all them niggas going? Nah, I got shut up. I only know Boston. Yeah, Flex.
Oh, Flex.
I only know Charlie.
That's it.
This is different type of talent with that. And then when I mean with that type of talent, that's one of those, yo, let me plug up, boom, boom. All right, put it, yo, Flex, give me a beat. That's different talent. You feel what I'm saying? And that's like natural from this guy right here. Like that's natural. And when I see that in him, it's like, damn, bro, I wish I can go motherfucking do that. Nigga, I'll be at motherfucking Flex like this. Yeah, put that shit on. Yeah, I'm like this. Yeah, I'm going running back. I'm running the beat back like, yeah, all right. This nigga just like, he's right there. I've been in the studio with him. Forrest. I've been in the studio with this guy, bro. I've been in the studio with him. It's crazy. But go back to what you said. I know we respect each other's craft, but there's a time where you just tell a nigga, like,
yo, you can see, we push each other further, bro.
You have it.
It's necessary.
Like, you know what I mean? As a, no bullshit, I look young, but I'm old as fuck. So, to me coming, I just did a lot of time.
Bro. 60 years, bitch.
What? I'm giving out. I stand on one.
Nigga, look like you missed the bus, nigga.
So, I look young. I'm old as fuck. I just did mad time in jail. So, me coming home to him being who he was, like, just think about this. I'm going to put it in perspective. When I left, I just did, like, what? All together. I'm not saying because I came home for a little short time. So all together, probably like 9 years straight.
Right.
Yeah. Like, damn. And I watched him as a young and me coming home to him blacking how he's blacking. So me looking at that, like, he's asking me to be on this big dog and he wrapped this shit over. I'm like, nah, I can't have this. Niggas ain't doing me like this. And that's what, and he encourages me not to do, he encourages me what he's not saying, to let him do me like he
not.
I'm not. I said I'm a vet, nigga. I'll put your dog.
And that no bullshit.
In other words, I shot your dog.
how can you not, though, when you got a person that did so much songs and he barely got cut in fucking old videos in all his videos.
Right.
He barely been in his videos.
Right.
And this is shit that I noticed. Like, I done been in the video where he's rapping, he ain't in the video.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, that's just how it is. Like, it's just.
I love these niggas, man. Energy crazy.
It's one of those. It's one of those. Like,
that's,
anybody
that's
in the world.
The type of shit we reciprocate.
It's one of those in the
like
world.
That's
with me. With me, anybody in the world, they want to be on a song with Jay-Z. It was one of those where I wanted to be on a song with certain niggas from my hood.
Right.
Like, because I was young. I'm 10, I'm 12, I'm 11.
It's the all-star team.
They coming up. Like, you feel what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, they looking at me like, yeah, youngin', we ain't put you on a song right now.
Not yet. Not
now
yet.
I'm here. Now it's like, nigga.
You never came to me with that. Oh, my God.
That was like, I can make the hit, you bitch ass nigga. So you gotta come
you
to me sometimes. Sometimes
you
gotta. You feel what I'm saying?
I'm not doing that.
I know.
He knows.
You pick and roll, nigga.
He knows.
Look, this dude, we don't play ball, but we them niggas with the long arms. Hammer tucked in my pants like they some long jumps. When I pull it out, these niggas singing like the thong song. Like, yo, this dude was amazing. I know everybody's shit. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like when I get on a song with them, yeah, I got 2G on. Everybody looking like, yeah, yo, 2G's on the song with me. These young motherfuckers don't know. Like, I'm in my hood, like, nigga, I am on the song with AR-15. I am on the song with. Y'all make it seem like I'm downplaying myself, but it's really, I'm younger. I'm younger. These are the vets in this game. You feel what I'm saying? So, it's real shit, bro. I wanted that as a young kid.
When you keep going back and forth, the niggas is like, yo, nigga, this is what's up.
Right.
That's what I tell yo. You know, older niggas than me, I tell them, like, yo, check this out. You know, I mean, niggas did a lot of prison time. They don't like to surround themselves with a lot of people. Yo, these dudes are going to be around. But, yo, because, you know what I mean, they valid in. Nigga, they going to tell you it's popping. Nigga, this is they ever, bro. So they tell you that shit ain't hot, gang.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? A lot of times it's like, yo, they ain't it, gang. I got my own feelings, my nigga. Mm. towards my music, but nigga, I gotta take constructive criticism.
Absolutely.
Or nigga, I'm every not artist an artist. You every know what artist. Saying? So I didn't.
Yo, one thing I wanted to start. One thing I wanted to really point out. No bullshit. And I've been really like dwindling over this shit. I've been kind of like trying to wonder if I want to take myself into that arena. But no bullshit, we need a fucking battle rap scene, bro. It's mad lyrical
talk
niggas.
Talk about it.
You
gotta set it up. Y'all gotta set it up.
No bullshit.
Cash.
Y'all gotta set it up.
And it's, bro, some, it's some niggas that I hear like shit. I be like, too. Yo, that was mean, clever. And niggas, I was... Yo, this shit got...
I don't know if we got a lot of battle rappers out here.
Nah, look.
I think...
No, hit me up. Hit me up. Hold on. Wait. Hit me up.
You don't got a lot of popular...
No.
Battle. No, hold on. There's a lot of, you don't got a lot of popular battle rappers, but you got a lot of rappers in this city that can battle rap that don't, we don't
who's
know.
The nigga that just bagged
$80?
Yeah, even him. Even his punk ass. But I'm you can cut that out. But listen, what I'm gonna say, that nigga was a great, he definitely was a nice punchline rapper. He definitely was a punchline rapper. I get my credit. Y'all not gonna make me a bad person.
Nah,
he's a creative rapper. He's a creative rapper. I swear to God. We got 8Ks like Arkansas. I know bars. You feel what I'm saying? Like I listen. I listen to music. I'm a musician. You feel what I'm saying? He was a creative person, bro. We lost a lot of people in Boston that do a lot of good things.
No cap.
Terrence Mann. What's the guy's name? Terrence Clark. Terrence Clark.
Yeah.
Like, you feel what I'm saying? There's a lot of people in our city. Not even just music, basketball, anything that we got a lot of people, bro. TC, RPTC. Yeah. Nah, bro. I ain't even know him. I'm just showing love to Boston. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, nah, I was
saying. Hey, yo, you was going to say something.
About the, like, I see a lot of lyrical shit. And when I say that, and no bullshit, right?
Niggas, right.
Nigga, I was just locked up. Like I said, I was just locked up. How long have I been out? Like 7-8 months? Yeah. Something like that. Something. Right. So, like, look.
Nine.
I was just locked. Yeah. I was just locked with Side Street Copper.
Yeah. Free you that hit, man.
Yeah, free him. Free Side Street Copper. I was on a unit rapping with this nigga. No bullshit. You hear how he raps. You hear the type of way he raps. Granted, like, the nigga's nasty. He's you know what I mean? He does what he does.
He can rap.
He has a whole nother dimension. Him, Free JJ Montega, like, no bullshit. Them niggas, we was really in a battle rap. Like, I'm literally eating my food. And then he comes up, smacks the table. Hey, y'all, what you? And he just gets crazy with me. And I'm sitting, and it really sounds like some smack DVD shit on Dog. Just randomly ambushed me. On Dog. And it's mad.
I don't
want
to go to jail, but that shit's not hell.
Look, it's mad niggas out here. It's my fault. It's mad niggas out here that can do that shit. I'm trying to tell you. And I'm here to murder all of y'all. I respect
you. I think the battle rap.
I'm here to murder all of y'all.
Don't you feel like that's like, I don't know, that's like shooting a star down? Like, what's your I mean the battle rap, like you could, he could crush a nigga who we think is ill.
Then don't jump in the arena. This is gladiation.
It's two different lanes. You see, Drake don't get into that battle lane. You feel what I'm saying?
I want Cypress, personally,
I'm a Drake. I'm not getting into the Cypress battle lane, but I won't do it.
It's a thing though when you battle rap.
Nobody off when you battle rap.
When you find a nigga that battle rap, that's like nice. I mean, this song's fire. This nigga just, he could do that. You know what I'm saying?
He's not a battle rapper that can make a song.
That's why you feel like
not
that.
Not a battle rapper that can make a song.
I'll tell you this much.
You won't see a nigga that can make a song battle rap.
That's true.
You talking about anomalies, bro. You talking about
service fire.
But what I'm saying is this. Drake can't battle rap, but when you beef with Drake on a record, he gonna tear you apart.
Let me ask you a question, nigga.
I think that's me.
Do you think Pusha T took that?
I think if it's battle rap, I can't really battle rap.
If Drake would have responded,
I can't really have the kid.
Because he didn't speak. I think I could.
Yeah.
If he was responding,
I feel like Pusha T got way messier. and way uglier.
It's battle, bro.
It was way more aggressive.
No, I think Drake always won that because at the end of it, you wanna know why Drake won that?
Fresh joint.
Because what is your drive? What is your drive to Drake. Coming at me and my son
Drake
that I don't want the world to know about? What is your drive?
Drake made diss records that became hits.
Yeah, back to back.
That's heavy.
There's no one stopping that.
That's heavy.
There's no one stopping
like,
that.
Like, for you to be able to make a diss record and get paid.
We're not going to really finish that conversation off by saying that he lost.
He won that battle. Drake won that.
I don't know if Drake won, but there's something to be said about how you could turn a diss record into
it. You know another category that y'all need to have by every artist that come up here? Rap in the streets, is that separated or is that the same?
So you feel what I'm saying? You talk about it, man.
I want to talk about it. Can I talk about it?
Well, my perspective, I'm going to let you go. I'm going to say two seconds. Or what I'm going to say, I watched the shit with Haitian Jack and all of them. You feel what I'm saying? And my theory on where it come from, without the streets, there's no hip-hop. And I'm going to just let you go right there. You feel what I'm saying? Without the streets, there's no hip-hop. And I'm going to let you go.
All right, that's cool. And that's real. But one thing that I kind of noticed about the day and age in music now, it's either two type of rappers. It's either you real enough to hear your story and some shit that can relate, or you nice as fuck, but you ain't got nothing to say. Right, it's always seemed like that.
Yeah, you got and something this going
is
with
where,
you
and this is what I say. Niggas right got there. Authentic right. shit
Ding dong.
With lyrics, with craft.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I can't speak listen to certain niggas and be like, all right, I hear that shit. I understand what he's talking about. I know this nigga personally.
Yeah.
But that shit ain't smacking what you saying. You ain't delivering that right.
Facts.
You ain't delivering it right. That and I'm not going to give you
though.
That. And then a nigga.
That go with Drake, though. Not to cut you off, gangster. That go with Drake, though. Niggas be beating me down like, yo, Drake is not Meek Mill. Cool. I know he's not Meek Mill.
Meek Mill's not Drake.
Yeah, he's not Meek. But Drake.
No, not
what
Meek
that
Mill.
What that person said about Drake, he said, Drake rapped about a conversation he had with a girl. He's rapping what he's doing.
He made a whole song about it.
He's rapping what he's doing. I don't give a fuck if he said I took a girl to the Ritz.
Even then, you're going to make somebody catch
him. There's layers. There's layers to
artistry. He's rapping what he's doing.
I give him that. But some of his shit,
he didn't start off gangster.
I don't be a lot.
He didn't start off gangster. Even on Ransom, he wasn't saying too much gangster.
Some of Drake shit, no bullshit. Every time I look at a song title and I see Drake on it, I'm going to listen to it.
Right.
I'm listening to it.
Yeah, right.
But some of his shit, I'd be disappointed as fuck. Like, you ain't talking about nothing. Mimosas and sosas and choses. I don't know. Nobody cares about that shit. No disrespect.
But
I don't care
about that. That's when he's tapping with the younger crowd. That's when he's trying to get into with the young crowd, the Fabios.
Right, you feel what I'm saying?
But when he do his own thing, he knows what is.
When he drinks, he knows where
it's supposed to be. But you got to tap in with the younger crowd to stay Drake.
Because, like, when y'all niggas wanted to drill, y'all niggas
one time,
I don't know what the fuck niggas said. Certain avenues that you can't cross, that's gonna stop niggas from banging that shit in the whip. That's all I'm saying. I can't. It's certain shit you can speak on the eye test, you can speak on the sales and shit. Like numbers don't lie. But when we talking about who got the streets soul wise, I can't bump no Drake on the
Drake.
Nigga think it's Soulja Boy.
You can say that, but I swear to God, and I'm going to put this on my dog.
Drake's the artist of the decade.
If Drake tapped in with one of the gangster niggas that you know, that's like rapping, Derek, that you listen to every day.
You're going to like the record.
And they do an EP together, they do a tape together, and Drake got the streets, nigga.
I promise you.
And he don't do a spec or nothing in the streets. He's going to rap everything you do, everything I do, everything the next nigga do.
Drake got.
And you're going to be like this. You heard what 50 said, you got to go to Drake to get your, to Ross. You got to go to Drake to get your hits. You can't make a hit by yourself. Any young nigga in the game will make a hit. Fabio, any gangster nigga that you fuck with rapping, Polo G, they do an EP with Drake about some gangster shit. You're fucking with it. He's gonna have the streets. That's just not his dream.
No, I can't say that.
I don't give a fuck.
Because when
he says, I'm coming to Drake.
Yeah, that's cool
when that nigga say putting that bag on somebody, nigga,
right, that's all he's talking about.
He got it.
Cause he can do it, but he's not doing it. But he can do it. That's what I mean about the topic of what does rap mean when you really like if a nigga's false rapping or real rapping, because he could really put a he could really buy some Balenciagas 10 times and those are $1,000. He could buy 10, and he's saying that in every song.
Well,
different ways.
There's we spoke about this briefly, like about studio rappers versus artists.
Yeah, but right. Even if, like, not even to cut you off, Charlie, even if, like, I don't, God's plan.
Right.
He not kicking no fucking kung fu, but that shit crazy. When I hear, I don't want nobody on no Charlie with me.
It's a timeless record.
Like, niggas, time, everlasting music, bro.
You can play that shit. You can play that shit at graduation.
Right, bro.
You play shit when your child's born.
That's a lie.
Come get me. You nigga, you can get fired from a job and play that shit.
God's plan. I ain't got no job, nigga. This is God's plan. He just do it. Everybody's doing in life, no matter what hood you from. If you in Minnesota, if you in Cali, Boston, wherever you are, he just raps. Some people just raps about what everybody go through in life. Like, look at Juice WRLD. He's still popping to this day. They about to drop something new.
Right.
What I mean, he's rapping about what the drug life the doing, the pills. Yeah. All them people is praising him.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Because they fighting that shit. They really fighting that shit. You feel what I'm saying? There's something that you just got to rap to the crowd that you,
crazy,
what you're fighting.
That sucks.
And you going to connect to that shit.
That shit fucked you up?
Yeah, nigga, I was in a drink. So when I was in the Juice WRLD, it's like, then you got Herb and I'm like, nigga, Juice WRLD. Because we don't know Juice WRLD.
You got Bibby and them coming up, and then you like, damn, Juice WRLD was with y'all.
Let me hear some motherfucking
2G, but it's real.
Can't want to hear some shit. Hold on.
Let's get this shit.
But it's real shit. It's real shit.
Y'all appreciate y'all.
Look, I appreciate y'all fellas coming up here, man.
Yes, sir.
This shit's been real. I love conversations where me and Cash don't really have to say much because y'all niggas' energy is crazy.
Right.
Y'all niggas dictated this whole fucking interview. Interviewed yourselves, nigga. Legendary hood shit, nigga.
Why you ain't doing shit, nigga? Yo, listen, these are the conversations.
This is me trying to get different people to tell them some shit that I'm trying to tell them, and they looking at me like, come on, you with me every day. And then when the next person's telling them that they not with every day, and you don't even think that they listening to your shit every day, and they hear it from them, they going to really do this shit. You feel what I'm saying? Like, yo, I really want a Godda project. I really want a 2G project.
We all want that.
And that's why I want them to understand, like, nigga, it's not built by one person. We all come together. We stick together like glue. Like, we like motherfucking handcuffs and shackles right now.
You got to know, too.
Let's go, nigga.
You got to know, too.
I'm the coach, man. I'm fucking Drizzy Drake. Oh, wait. Like, I told y'all. I'm Drizzy Drake.
Yo, Meechie,
I want to do the courses. I want to come on my little verses.
Drop that handle, yo. Drop that CWTFB
radio.
Hey, yo, man. We are live on CWTFB radio, my man. Chizza. It's Meechie Columbia, and I'm here with 2GP, and I'm here with motherfucking AR-15. Gotta. And y'all know what time it is, man. How we coming?
You know what the fuck time it is,
man. Somebody wanna pull you like chisel, three times.
This CWTFB radio, man. I'm Charlie MaSheen, my man Cash, no money, man. We out of here.